So. Es ist gerade die NCC also on the server. However, Mi Quattro vs. Danik B will be the match. They make one more warm-up and then they will go live. The format is that they try 1v1, of course. Three maps. And it's best of three, actually. So you have to win two maps. And then you are the winner of this match. The maps will be played until 7 points. And with tennis mode, as far as I know. Man versus man is a tag competition. So you have proper tag maps here. And I guess this will be a very close match. Mi Quattro is one of the best players from Finland over all the years. And Danik B. Also Mi Quattro qualified for the Team Champions League season. And we have Danik B, the Czech player that also qualified for Team CL season. And I will play with Danik B in the Trackman United competition in the next month. So he's kind of a teammate, he was already earlier teammate. So I'm gonna cast him. And I think that this will be a very close match. You already saw in the warm-up that they are very equally skilled. Maps are not too difficult. Here we go, first round. Danik B versus Mi Quattro. So map starts with a full speed start, going through the CP. Danik B with a better slide. Oh, we have a restart by Skadi. Okay, here we go again. This time Mi Quattro with a better start, Danik B with more speed, however. Yeah, completely equal here. Now on this left-hander. Mi Quattro a little bit behind. So wider line here. Still a bit behind. 500s only. Coming into the second half of the track. This right-hander looks very equal between both players, going through the poles into this left drift. Oh, Mi Quattro with the attack on the inside, but doesn't have that much speed as Danik B, and Danik B takes the first round with 900s. That was a good round already, and I guess we will see a lot of good rounds here. This is how close it is. 89,000. 89. I just had to say it. And yeah. First point goes to Danik B. Second round starting. In the past, 1v1 matches often started with a 1v1 score after two rounds. Let's see if that will also happen here in this match. Ooh, that was tight for Mi Quattro, but he came through. That brings him back into the game. Ooh, a bit wide there as well, but he has more speed, so he is ahead of Danik B at the moment in this round. But very risky approaches by Mi Quattro in some of these turns. He extends his lead here. Very good lap so far. Only three drifts remaining, I guess. This right-hander looks nice. Mi Quattro stays in the front, 2400. This left-hander also worked, and now this is the last turn. Going inside, he makes it. And this is a 0.57. The fastest time so far in this match, if I'm not mistaken. We see the Dedimanias, 55.19 by Kappa. Omnipods, Kronos, Razor, and there we have this Ratchet guy. I'm not sure who it is, actually. Also Matze. Oh yeah, 57 is already pretty good. Next round, and we have the 1v1 score that I mentioned. Mi Quattro with a little bit of better start, but this time Danik B with more speed out of this corner. Mi Quattro in second. Danik B going wider, but has more exit speed. So he stays in the front, extends his lead a little bit. Oh, Mi Quattro loses a lot of speed in this corner, and will lose a lot of time with that. Oh, but Danik B here, I guess he got a gear down. So now they are equal in this checkpoint. Both had some problems, both had not the best turns, no crashes, but slowdowns, and now it's decided in the very last corners. Danik be a little bit behind, but he had the better endings, I felt like. But no, not this time. Mikrotro stays ahead with a 0.77. He takes the second point of the match for himself. But yeah, you see, all the rounds are close. The players are not crashing until now. Mikrotro seems to be a little bit faster at the moment. So let's stay at Danik B. Mikrotro more speed out of the first drift. Danik B, the better angle for the second drift, and he goes into the lead again. White line. Ah, he had to release. Danik B had to release, and there you see how much that costs in such a tight 1v1 situation. Also here he had to release a little bit. And now it's over 1500 that he is behind. 2/10. Not 2500s. Another good opportunity for Mikrotro to take his third point and getting closer to the first map win. He seems to be very nice here. Oh, whoa. Oh, Danik B actually touching it, but it was also tight for Mikrotro. He drives a 0.64, so yeah, very consistent times. He had a 0.5, a 0.6 here, 0.7 previous round, and first round was, I guess, also 0.7. Very consistent performance so far. And now Danik B needs to get a bit faster in order to win some rounds. Another tight start. Mikrotro a little bit ahead. 200s. Nice turn by both players. This time Danik B didn't release, was close with the outside wall. But Mikrotro also took it nicely here. Mikrotro some little different lines, but the exit is basically how they entered it. Oh wow, Danik B goes wide, touches the ramp sign a bit, loses some speed. Now the gap is almost a 10th to Mikrotro, who didn't have any stumbles in this round so far, but seems to be a good round. Good times coming up here. Mikrotro also has more speed out of this corner, now the last corner, keep the gear, come through this chicane, and Mikrotro takes the next one with a 0.55, Danik B with a 0.70, really really good stuff by Mikrotro, very consistent, around 4 to 5 tenths behind the world record in, well, in rounds, the rounds world record. I don't know if the 19 is really the record, but well, 4 to 1. Looks good for Mikrotro. But three more rounds that he needs to win. And Danik B is very consistent. One mistake and Danik B takes it. And that was close for Mikrotro, but it came through this corner. Oh, sick turn by Danik B. With a little ramp cut in the start, and he gets a huge lead there. And also Mikrotro now stumbles with the gears in this corner. So this is a good opportunity for Danik B to take a second point. And very important as well, because 1-5 would be too much, and there goes Mikrotro into the wall. Let's see what time Danik B is driving. Can save it pretty much, but usually they just keep their lines, and it's safe for the stadium tech guys already. Yeah, oh, 0.46, so yeah, Danik B is fast enough. He drove it a bit in the wrong round, I must say. In all the previous rounds he could have needed it, but now Mikrotro crashed anyway. But yeah, sick time, 0.46, the best time of the match. But Danik B needs to repeat it. Because in this round, as I said, it wasn't that helpful. Now he would have also won with a 0.7 or 0.8. But okay, he put some pressure on Mikrotro due to his very fast start. That's of course also true. And there goes Mikrotro into the wall. So now Danik B needs to get the next CP, and then he knows it. There he is in the CP. Now he should see that he's ahead in the interface. If he makes it on for that little moment. You see Mikrotro is pretty far behind. It's almost a second. So this looks very good for Danik B to take the third point. And then we have a close match again. Just one point that he's behind. I think here we see that he saves it a lot. Oh yeah, it's just half a second now. It was almost a second, now it's just half a second. So Danik B now really saved. Oh, he goes all white! You see how close we Quattro actually came. Danik V is only driving a 0.39. This was really the safe meister lines that Danik V put out there. We Quattro really caught up a lot in this round, but it was not enough. It was nicely saved by Danik V. 4-3 for Mi Quattro. Next round started. So far so good. Danik B a bit more inside at the exit, but with less speed. Mi Quattro going for a very wide line. He has more speed, but overall it didn't pay off. Danik B with a little lead, but this turn was good for Mi Quattro. They are side by side now. Last TP showed 0.000, now it's just 1000. Mi Quattro super close to the wall, gets a little bit more speed out of this corner. Danik B a bit behind, has to push it in the last corner. It's 36,000, and Mi Quattro has the better exit here. It's 400s in the finish, 0.49 versus 0.53. What a round. And very important for Mi Quattro. And now Danik B actually loses with a 0.53. A bit unlucky this match so far. He lost many close rounds. But yeah, this is how it goes. A 0.4 is a really strong time by Mi Quattro. Super good round. 5-3. But Danik B looks very stable. He didn't make a single mistake yet. Mi Quattro with a better start, and these last turns are not too difficult, I wanted to say, and there he goes, Mi Quattro, into the wall. That was a little jinx, I guess. That pushes Mi Quattro over a second behind. Danik B can save it now. Let's 4-5. 0.58 in the finish for Danik B. I guess there is a match where a player drives a 55.555. I'm pretty sure of that. Very likely to happen. Ah, okay. Thanks a lot, Yaktor. Oh, Mi Quattro with another stumble, and this might be now the equal, the 5-5. So yeah, Danik B definitely the more consistent player. Very stable, didn't really make a lot of mistakes, or not at all, until now. And Mi Quattro, yeah, lost a few rounds now due to mistakes, but he seems to be overall the faster player by a little bit. He won many close rounds, so he definitely is able to handle the pressure in tight rounds. He won all of them, so this is the situation right now. Danik B finishes with a 0.81, 5-5, and as far as if I understood correctly, we have tennis mode enabled here. And on the first map, they might take use of that. Now, very important round. Whoever wins this round has the first match point. Danik B with a little bit better start. You see that Mi Quattro took this corner much safer now. He didn't want to crash it again, but it puts him behind by 1200, and now he needs to risk because of that. Takes a wider approach for more exit speed, but remains the same distance to Danik B. Now Mi Quattro has a little bit more speed, he comes closer. 700s. Danik B going very far outside for a better exit, but Overall, Mi Quattro came closer. Two drifts remaining, Mi Quattro giving it all. And now the last turn, Mi Quattro had good last turns. He always goes a bit more inside. He's too far outside now here. Danik B will go through again and takes this very important sixth point. And this is the match point for him on the first track. Very, very sick fight so far. Close rounds. So let's have a look at Danik B. This is his chance to take the first map. Oh, this time Danik B had to drift multiple times and lost a lot of time with that. Mi Quattro this time ahead. Danik B needs to risk it. Of course, huge pressure now on Mi Quattro because one mistake and this map is lost. So even if he's ahead, this is not an easy situation for him. Danik B going very wide, avoids the ramps, then has lots of speed. Still a bit behind though, but he came closer. Good turn for Mi Quattro. Extends his lead by a little bit. And now just one turn remaining. And Mi Quattro got it. 6-6. 46 is the time by Mi Quattro. Sick time. In such a situation. I mean, he's 5-6 down. Danik B had the momentum. And then Mi Quattro puts out a point 46. Really, really sick. So here we go. Tennis mode. Quattro gets more speed here, overtakes Danik B by, yeah, 100. Different approaches here, Mi Quattro with a lot of exit speed, that looks very good. Danik B now in second place. And also this turn was much better for Mi Quattro. Oh, but Danik B has a good turn here and now they are tight again. We saw them tight so often in this section. Danik B always going more outside here, this is a bit too outside. Had to adjust this line, but he comes still out of the corner ahead of Mi Quattro. But this left turn is so good for Mi Quattro. Now the last turn will decide that Danik B going for more outside, for more speed. This will be so close. Danik B overtakes by 9,000. 0.63 versus 0.64. What a round. What a round. At the tennis mode. Sick. And there's another option now for Danik B to take this map. And then there are people that say 1v1 is boring. Just watch this match. Incredible. Mi Quattro, a little bit behind. He has to win this round, otherwise Danik B is the winner of this first map. Mi Quattro takes more speed, they are equal again. This left-hander, Danik B gets it usually very nicely also now, he is ahead again. Good chance, good opportunity for Danik B to take it home. But Mi Quattro is close and he has more speed. Mi Quattro will pass Danik B. And this left-hander was always a good turn for Mi Quattro as well in this round. Danik B now behind, last turn remaining. Danik B tries it all and he might overtake again. Yes, he will. And with a 0.55, he beats Mi Quattro with a 0.57. In the end, Danik B was able to win the close rounds finally. And this was the reason why he is the winner of the first track. What a nice fight between those two guys. Amazing. 8-6 is the score of the first track. Yo, hello Carcrox. So, we will go to the second track. Danik asks for warm-ups. I guess that this is a warm-up. I mean, they just drive now and there are no warm-ups on the server. but I can't believe that they are live already. But in case they would be live, Miquatro is ahead. I guess we will see after this round what Miquatro answers. If that's live or not. But you see that also on this track both players are very trained. Ah yeah, they have to reset the points. Score first map 8-6 for Danik B. Super close it was. The last two rounds in the tennis mode were both decided by 100. That was an ultra sick first map. So, it's live now, second map starting, Danik B versus Miquatro. Live we go. Danik B with an early lead, but the first drift is better for Miquatro. He comes back, ooh, this was super close. Also here, Miquatro stumbling a little bit. Danik B extends his lead. And now we go over this platform part, Danik B extending his lead 2400. So I don't know this map, I have to learn it first, but there was a tight section in the end, as I saw in the warm-up. Still, Danik B nicely in the lead. Now coming to this section, Miquatro has a better angle and the finish jump. Might also be very interesting, it's just 700 in the finish. The more inside you jump into that finish, the better, of course. And sometimes you really win a lot by a more inside line. You win much more than you would think. So you can take huge risks in this finish jump for sure. Only 700 in this first round, even though Miquatro seemed to be far behind. But yeah, first point goes to Danik B. If he wins this map as well, then he is the winner of this match and will move on to the quarterfinals. This time Miquatro with a better start. Danik B behind, but gets more speed out of this corner and passes Miquatro, stumbles a bit, but he always takes this line where he wiggles a bit with his wheels. Different approaches for this turn. Miquatro takes more exit speed, still a bit behind before the next drift. Needs to jump a bit out of this drift. That leaves Danik B in the front. Also here Danik B with a much better angle. And now it's just this one drift. And this looks good for Danik B to get the second point. Ooh, Danik B jumping so safe into the finish. So far outside. But yeah, he could afford it in this round. He had enough of a gap to Miquatro. So it's a 10th now. Time of from Danik B was a 52.0. You see it in the Daddy Manias, Dexter with a 0.54. 51.54. However, we go to the next round and Miquatro with an early crash. So this is one of the few rounds that we only had in this match so far where someone crashed. Usually it is Miquatro that crashes. Danik B didn't have a single crash in the whole match yet. But yeah, this will hurt Miquatro now because he's already 2 points down and this will be the third point. Very good opportunity for Danik B to take home this match win on this track. Of course, he has the momentum now, winning the first track so close. And he seems to be more stable on the second map. He has his lines and just drives them. He'll probably be safe it here. Yeah, 52.33. But it's enough for Danik B. Yeah, I see it in chat already. This is Miquatro's worst map and so far it does really look like it. He really needs to win now, this round. If he doesn't win, it might be too difficult to catch up again. Oh, going full over the hole and there is Danik B with his first little mistake. But he's still in the round. However, Danik B now behind, Oh my god, Mi Quattro! Again, he jumps out of this corner and this time he couldn't make it. He throws away this good chance to take home a round win. And this is Danik B now, probably getting the next win. And a 4-0 lead. So this is a very different match to the first map. This time we have a pretty big domination regarding the points at least. Mi Quattro could have won this and it was very, very important to win. Will be difficult for him to come back into this match. Only 3 more rounds that Danik B needs to win. Good start for both players. In this section Danik B usually gets more exit speed. Again in this round. And also here in this platform turn Danik B has the better line. This is the part where he usually wins some time on Mi Quattro. This is the same in every single round. And this is just too big of a gap for Mi Quattro. Mi Quattro has better finish jumps, I think. But he was never close enough to really take advantage from that. Mi Quattro again too tense behind Danik B. And this is just too much. He can't get this with a tighter finish jump. This, he tries, you see. He wins a bit of time, but it's not enough. And what times? Wow. 0.78 for Danik B. So Mi Quattro had a good time here, he had a good round, but he drove it in the wrong round. It's a bit unlucky for him that he still didn't win a single round, but Danik B is doing a really good job. And now it's only 2 more rounds that he needs to win. Can Mi Quattro do a comeback? I mean, there were some 1v1s that I've seen already, where a player was 6-0 in the lead, which will happen also now, but then still lost. It happened in Canyon once. Suiram versus Quentin. It was. Quentin was in the lead 6-0, but lost 6-7. So it's never over. But in this match I see it might be too difficult to really catch up. Danik B looks so consistent, so stable. Still, not a single crash, just maybe a little bit of a gear down here and there, but that's everything that he had. No wall crashes or something, so Mi Quattro needs to be super consistent and much faster if he wants to win this match. Last round. Let's spectate Danik B. Will he take it? Super close first map, second map so far. A clear domination. You can assume if the first map would have been won by Mi Quattro, then Danik B probably wouldn't be that good on the second track now. He had the momentum coming from the first track with a win, and he takes over the lead again in this section. It's always the same section. Now this turn where Mi Quattro always gets a little jump and yeah, this is not good. He loses more time and now it looks really good for Danik B. It is just one more drift and the finish jump. And the finish jump is not too difficult. He can save it again. He can save it. And there we go. GG! 51.85 to close it out. Very well done by Danik B. So he moves on to the quarterfinal. Mi Quattro out. A very good performance. And sick first map.